Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to discuss the tree sort process. How can we do the tree sort process? First, we arrange the elements in a binary search tree, and then we perform the inorder traversal along the binary search tree. What is the detail of this traversal? We recursively find the left subtree, and then we get the root of the subtree, and then we recursively find the right subtree. And that is the major idea of the traversal process, which is a recursive one. So what does it mean by a binary search tree? A binary search tree has three conditions to follow. First, the left subtree of a node has the elements that are smaller than the node, and the right subtree of a node has elements that are larger than the node. Finally, each subtree satisfies the above two conditions. Then we can say that we have a binary search tree. Let's take a look at this example of a binary search tree. Now I'm going to verify that this one is a binary search tree. First, we see that the left subtree of node 16 has elements that are all smaller than the node. Now we can take a look at this diagram. The left subtree of node 16 is already confined by the dashed lines, and we can see that this subtree has elements that are all smaller than 16. And then we can take a look at the right subtree of node 16. We can see that the right subtree has elements that are all larger than the node. So we see the dashed line region has elements that are all larger than 16. And then we can find another subtree of node 3, which is the right one. And we can see that the right subtree of node 3 has elements that are all larger than the node. So the dashed line region tells us that all the elements in that region are larger than the node, which is 3. And we can also see that the left subtree of node 12 has elements that are all smaller than the node. So the left subtree is 9 only, and this element is of course smaller than the node. And when we take a look at the right subtree of node 12, we can see that the right subtree has elements that are all larger than the node. So the only element is 15 for that right subtree. So this element is larger than the node itself. So the description is satisfied. And then we can take a look at the left subtree of node 21. We see that there is only one element for that subtree, which is 17, and we can see that 17 is smaller than 21. And the right subtree of 21 has elements that are all larger than the node, and we can see that the right subtree is 25, and 25 is of course larger than 21, which is the node. After understanding the meaning of a binary search tree, we can really do this tree sort process. Suppose we want to sort these elements. The first step is to arrange these elements in a binary search tree. How can we do the arrangement? We have to start building the binary search tree from the first element, and we put the first element into the root position of the binary search tree. So now 21 is put into the root position. And then the next number is 45. Since 45 is larger than 21, 45 becomes the right child of node 21. The next number to handle is 31. Since 31 is larger than 21, 31 belongs to the right subtree of 21. And also, since 31 is smaller than 45, we can say that 31 has to be the left child of 45. That's why 31 is put here. The next value to put into the binary search tree is 50. And since 50 is larger than 21, 50 belongs to the right subtree of 21, and at the same time, 50 is larger than 45. That means 40 has to become the right child of 45. That's why 50 is put here. The next element is 72, and we see that 72 is larger than 21. That means 72 has to belong to the right subtree of 21. And at the same time, 72 is larger than 45. So 72 has to belong to the right subtree of 45. Also, 72 is larger than 50. That means 72 has to become the right child of 50. That's why 72 has to be put to the lower right-hand corner of the binary search tree. The next number to handle is 12, and 12 is smaller than 21. That means 12 becomes the left child of 21. The final element to handle is 15. Since we see that 15 is smaller than 21, we know that 15 has to belong to the left subtree of 21. And also, since 15 is larger than 12, 15 has to become the right child of 12. And after handling all the elements, we can say that the binary search tree is finished. And then we can really do the traversal process. We start with the root, which is 21. And we try to find the left subtree from the root recursively. That's why we can focus on the left subtree indicated by the dashed line box. We start with 12 now and find the left subtree of element 12. Since there is no element belonging to the left subtree of 12, we just take the root of that subtree, which is 12, and we put 12 into the first element of our final answer. After traversing the root, we have to traverse the right subtree of 12. So we start with 15. And then for 15, we find out the left subtree. And we see that the left subtree of 15 has nothing. That's why we just take 15 into the final answer as the second element. And we also try to start with 15 again and find its right subtree. And since we have no right subtree for element 15, we stop the traversal at this stage. And we can also see that the left subtree of node 21 is already finished. Since the left subtree of 21 is finished, we put the parent node 21 into the final answer, which becomes the third element of the sorted answer. And then we start with the right subtree from the root recursively. That's why we start with 45. And from 45, we try to find out the left subtree, which is now 31. And we start with 31 again, and we are trying to find out the left subtree of 31, but there is nothing for the left subtree of 31. That's why we take the root 31 to become the sorted answer, which becomes also the fourth element of our final answer. And then we start with 31 again, and we are trying to find out the right subtree of 31. And unfortunately, we have no right subtree for that element. And at this time, we can also realize that the left subtree of 45 is finished. Since the left subtree of 45 is finished, we take the parent node 45 to the final answer, which becomes the fifth element of our final answer. After that, we find the right subtree of 45 recursively. So we start from 45, and we can find out that particular right subtree indicated by the dashed line box. And then from that subtree, we start from the element 50, and we are trying to find out the left subtree of that element. Unfortunately, we cannot find the left subtree. That's why we take the root, which is 50, to the final answer, which becomes the sixth element of our final answer. And then, after finishing the node, we have to traverse the right subtree of 50. And we see that we have only one element in the right subtree of 50. And we start with 72 to find out the left subtree of it. And unfortunately, we cannot find any left subtree of 72. And when we traverse to the root recursively, we can take 72 to the final answer. That's why 72 becomes the final element that is traversed by following the inorder traversal. This is not the end of the story. We have to also see whether 72 has right subtree or not. Unfortunately, 72 has no right subtree. And at the same time, the bigger right subtree indicated by the node 45 is finished. And at the same time, the larger right subtree of node 21 is also finished. In this case, we can say that the entire inorder traversal is finished. That means the tree sort process is now complete. In order to visualize the traversal process, we can have a diagram like this one. We start from the left hand side of the root, and then we traverse all the bottom dots on each of the elements. So the dots are indicated in red, and they are put at the bottom of each of the elements. If we start with the root, which is 21, we can do the inorder traversal as follows. When we follow the arrows, we can see that we can get the sorted numbers. If I follow the order and write down those numbers, I'm able to get the sorted list again. So this is a way to help us visualize the inorder traversal. And we can also see the recursion process more clearly from this diagram. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions at the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.